I know this is the first time that you're hearing the president's tweet read to you. So when he says that you've totally fabricated what he said to the wife of the soldier and he has proof, what's your response?
Well, I don't know what kind of proof he could be talking about. I'm not the only person that was in the car. And I have proof, too. This man is a sick man. He's cold-hearted, and he feels no pity or sympathy for anyone. This is a grieving widow who is 6 months pregnant. This is a young woman. She's only 24 years old. She weighs maybe 110 pounds. And she has two other kids, 2 years old and 6 years old. And when she actually hung up the phone, she looked at me and said, he didn't even know his name. Now, that's the worst part.
So, Congressman, let's talk about that. What did you hear? Tell us about this phone call.
Well, I didn't hear the whole phone call, but I did hear him say, I'm sure he knew what he was signing up for, and but it still hurts.
So that's how you interpreted it. You interpreted it as the president saying something callous in that way. Obviously, it can be heard lots of different ways. It could be heard as the president trying to find some point of understanding to speak out to the widow. How did she hear it? What was her response?
She was crying. She broke down. And she said, he didn't even know his name. So
Did you hear the part where they left the impression that he didn't know his name?
She heard the part that he didn't know his name. And I don't think we should be trying to go into all of this. What the concern is, we have a soldier who died from Miami Gardens. And there are so many circumstances surrounding his death that I still have questions about.